Deep in forests across the country, people are growing illegal drugs, and the operations are causing environmental damage that drives animals from their habitats. Alexa Liaco went with forest rangers to see how they're restoring the land.
Most of this Northern California forest remains wild.
We have this amazing, abundant wildlife. Nature up here.
This sacred space, one U.S. Forest Ranger Chris McGowan swore to defend.
Our duty is to protect our national forests and our public lands and preserve it for future generations. That's what drives us to be up here.
But here, hidden in places almost too difficult to find.
No, it's just regular fertilizer.
Okay. The forest is being poisoned.
And you just found a bag of fertilizer next to, a can of Spam.
Yep, exactly.
This is what's left of an illegal marijuana grow.
So over here, we have what's left of the stalks.
This makeshift manufacturing hub is a campsite like you've never seen, and more are popping up every year.
And then all this was their kind of sleeping and living area?
That's correct. So you can see how they dug out the side of the hill here, so they'd have a flat part, to sleep. Or maybe this is where their trim area was.
The rangers are here to dismantle this intrusion. These Forest Service photos of other camps show growers hike in or build everything they need for months.
I've seen all kinds of everything from they make their own kind of flush toilet out there. I've seen gym equipment they made using wood for barbells. I've seen where they had a poker table set up.
But these creature comforts leave the forest a mess. Growing these plants takes much away from this land. Clean water is siphoned off through these black tubes.
And it's a theft. So this is actively, publicly stealing the public's waterways. You're talking of millions of gallons of water that are being taken annually. Now, that's a huge impact during a drought season when water is so precious for municipalities, indigenous tribes, public's use, and even firefighting.
But it's the wildlife that's one of the most devastating losses.
X-rated buckets that we can put the carbapenem in.
Greta Wingert is a conservationist working with the Forest Service. She says some pesticides used at these grows aren't even legal in the United States.
This stuff is so toxic that even just a quarter teaspoon can kill an adult black bear. So, sometimes we'll go out and we'll see little tuna can containers that have just a little bit of this pink residue, and it's out there specifically to kill animals.
The growers do this to protect the marijuana and themselves from predators.
And that's heartbreaking. It's sad to see the animals that are dead. It's sad to see the water diversions. It's sad to see the chemicals. It's heartbreaking. And so that's what makes it so important.
All of the trash has to be carted out of here, including the irrigation lines, all the trash from camp. And if it's not hiked out, using a helicopter is the only way to get the teams in and out of the most treacherous grow sites because of the steep terrain. And they also use that same long line to haul out tons and tons of trash.
So we're knocking out two sites a day.
But knowing the damage that's being done only pushes this team to work harder.
It angered me to know that Americans' public lands are sort of under siege from this. So I get angry, I get really upset, but it's also energizing, and we're all determined to make it right.
Just this year, they've cleared nearly two dozen illegal grow sites, and they've removed more than 17,000 pounds of garbage and hazardous chemicals like this.
We are in the middle of nowhere. We don't have the resources, we don't have the funding, but we're here. And we work together as a team.
And McGowan says they do it because this land is meant to be safe, meant to be clean for all of us.
This is not about cannabis. This is about our environment and about protecting our environment and making it safe so a family can enjoy their public lands.
For The Race, I'm Alexa Liaco.
We'll introduce you to the dogs that are scouring mountains looking for a certain type of bee when The Race continues.